What's up guys, it's Aaron here. Today I'll be talking about how I take notes on my iPad and laptop for university, as well as why I choose to use OneNote on the iPad instead of other applications like GoodNotes or Notability. So stick around if you're a student and interested in learning more, but first I'm gonna get myself a cup of coffee. Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Gorgeous, make them drop dead, you a killer. Shower you with all my attention. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Stay in the kitchen, cooking up, get your own bread. Heart full of equity, you're an asset. Make sure that you don't need no mentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Shout out to your mom and dad for making you. Staying in a vision, they did a great job raising you. When I create, you're my muse. The kind of smile that makes the news. Can't nobody throw shade on your name in these streets. Triple threat, you a boss, you a bank, you a beast. You make it easy to choose. You got a mean touch, you can't refuse. No, I can't refuse it. So just to give you guys my background, I'm a senior student studying in a business and economics program, and I took notes on paper and with my laptop for most of my first year and a half of college, and slowly transitioned to using digital notes once I got my Surface Book and later my iPad. So currently I use the 2020 iPad 8, which is the cheapest tablet from Apple. And if you haven't seen my previous video on why I chose this tablet instead of the other iPads from Apple, I'll link it on the screen right now. But I won't go into too much detail in this video about the benefits of taking notes digitally versus on paper. I honestly find it a lot more convenient to take notes digitally because everything is in one place and it's really easy to search through when I'm reviewing. And it also lets me be much neater when I'm working with a lot of graphs or equations in my economics courses. So I use OneNote by Microsoft for all of my notes, and I pretty much only use Microsoft Word now when I'm doing assignments or essays where I need the extra formatting options because I'm going to be submitting something. OneDrive is also my cloud-based storage of choice over Google Drive now because all of my notes and files are saved directly on OneNote, which is synced on OneDrive. So the first main reason I use OneNote over other note-taking apps is because of the built-in organizational features. The app lets you organize your notes into different notebooks, and then within that you have sections and then pages. So I typically create a new notebook for each class that I take, and within that I create different sections for different types of notes. So for example, I usually create a section for lecture slides, one for reading notes, one for homework and problem sets that I do, and as many as I need to separate the different types of notes that I have. I don't have the most structured approach to taking notes, but the first thing that I always do is export lecture slides that are usually in PowerPoint or PDF format into OneNote to annotate directly and make notes on. You can do this through the export function on your iPad, similar to how you would do it on GoodNotes or Notability, but I find it a lot easier to just do it on my laptop and then access the slides on my iPad since all of it is connected through OneNote. This brings me to the second main reason why I use OneNote, and that's because it has great cross-platform compatibility. So out of the three main note-taking apps, OneNote, Notability, and GoodNotes, OneNote has the best cross-platform compatibility since it's available on any device and platform, whether it be your tablet, PC, Mac, or smartphone. So whenever you're writing notes on your iPad, it'll sync in real time to all of your other devices, so you can take additional notes on your laptop, or you can access and edit your notes on your smartphone if you'd like as well. I know that Notability and GoodNotes have a Mac version, but I know it's not nearly as optimized as OneNote for PC and Mac, and a lot of students, including myself, don't use a MacBook but have an iPad, so getting that cross-platform compatibility is only available on OneNote. Another thing is that since OneNote is integrated with OneDrive, you have access to live sharing of notes. So if you'd like to work on notes with your friends or collaborate on any sort of document, you can all work together on the same page, similarly as you would on Google Drive, but directly within OneNote. And finally, just some other features that I really like about OneNote and wanted to point out. OneNote doesn't have a size limit for the pages, so every page you open is infinitely usable and you can write or type on anywhere in the page. I find this really useful for making notes on lecture slides since you can write anywhere when you're tight on space, in between lines, or even to the side of the lecture. There's also a customizable pen bar at the top of OneNote, so if you write with different colors or types of pens, you'll save a lot of time from having to manually switch between different types of pens every single time. And finally, OneNote is the only app out of the three that is completely free. Honestly, I wouldn't mind paying for the app though. I still think even if it was paid, I would choose it over GoodNotes and Notability for the reasons that I mentioned previously. But that's it for this video. Hopefully you found it helpful or entertaining in some way. And if you did, dropping a like and subscribing is really appreciated. Feel free to comment any questions you have or send me a DM on Instagram. But until next time, I'll see you guys in the next video. It's your birthday.